हेलो, नाउ यू आर गेटिंग माय वॉइस। आर यू गेटिंग माय वॉइस नाउ? ओके
यस
ओके, नाउ इट्स अ आई थिंक इट्स अ गुड नाउ। ओके, तो गुड। सो नाउ द सेकेंड ऑब्जेक्टिव इज लर्न द ग्रामर एंड द ट्यूरिंग मशीन। नाउ एज वी ऑलरेडी ऑलरेडी नो दैट द ग्रामर इज वॉट, हाउ द लैंग्वेज इज मेड अप ऑफ, हाउ द लैंग्वेज इज मेड अप ऑफ। बिकॉज टू लर्न एनी लैंग्वेज वी लर्न टू थिंग्स, वन इज कॉल्ड एज अल्फाबेट्स एंड सेकेंड इज कॉल्ड एज द ग्रामर। द ग्रामर इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट। इफ यू लर्न द ग्रामर, द लैंग्वेज लर्निंग द लैंग्वेज इज नॉट अ बिग टास्क। Because as if suppose I want to learn the English language, the learning the English language is nothing but learning the alphabets A to Z, capital and small. But I must understand the grammar, how to use that alphabet to make a sentence, to make a word, to make a meaningful sentence. So that meaning is called as a semantic, and how to write is called as syntax. So that is grammar. So learning the grammar is very important. Because if you learn the grammar, yes, you can learn any language. So this learning the grammar, so in this grammar is not related with any particular language. It is more over related to the mathematical model, the computing model, how to draw the computing model. For that drawing the computer model or to forming the computing model, this grammar is going to help us. So learning the grammar and learning a new concept, new words, called as a Turing machine. Now in this subject, we'll have the number of new words. That new words are not that much difficult, but yes, first time we are learning that, hearing that, so we might feel that it is somewhat different or it's somewhat difficult. But no, it's just name given to something. Because this subject is more over the mathematical things, and many of us already knowing that the Egyptian, the Greek, they are more devoted towards the mathematics. Because if you find the more of the mathematicians are the Greek, stands for Greek or Roman. So we are having the Greek word alpha, beta, gamma, Roman words or Roman alphabets in the numbering. So these words belongs to the somewhat to the Greek language or the Roman language. So that words are new for us. But that new word don't make any changes in the concept. So the concept will remain the same, very simple, but the words, yes, Turing, you are hearing the, might be hearing the word Turing, but it's a Turing is a name of a scientist who actually made this machine. Machine means what? Model, computing model. So he made that computing model first, initially. So that's why that machine, that model is named as a Turing machine. So learning the Turing machine, what that Turing machine content of, or how it actually process that model works, that everything we'll going to learn in this subject. So second objective is very clear, learning the grammar and learning the Turing machine, how to draw the Turing machine for a specific problem statement. If I want to perform the addition of two number, so how to draw the Turing machine for that? So that we'll draw with the help of the concepts, what we will learn into the Turing machine. If the problem is computing the factorial, so we'll draw the Turing machine for the factorial. So for every problem statement, the Turing machine is going to be changed. But the logic will remain the same, but Turing machine will be different. So in this Turing machine, we'll have the number of problems that Turing machine, draw the Turing machine for this, draw the Turing machine for another problem, like that. So that is your course objective two. Now the last course objective is to learn about the theory of computation and the complexity. So you might be knowing the complexity word in your second year, data structure, time complexity. And the second is what? The space complexity. So space complexity is what space your program will require in the memory when you are executing that program. So that is called a space complexity, and how much time it will take for execution. That is called a time complexity. You are already knowing this in your data structure. So how to make the theory of computation So we'll have the different case studies. We can call it as a case studies, and using that case studies and how that complexity of that problem is. So drawing the Turing machine and calculating the theory of computation for the different test cases of theory of computation and the complexity. We will have the number of problems, NQN problem or the Kruskal problem. So with the help of that, we are going, we'll try to learn this subject called as the theory of computation. So these are the three basic course objectives of theory of computation, course objective. Now, the after that course objective, there are called as a course outcome. Means after the learning the course, what you are able to do, what you are able to do, what you are capable of doing after learning the subject, that comes under the course outcomes. So course objective is before starting the thing is called as objective. If you want to start any work, so suppose you want to learn the cricket. So initially, what you will decide? Yes, for learning the cricket, my objective is to get selected into the Maharashtra team or your regional team. My second objective is learning the good technical things or techniques of your batting or bowling. Next objective is to get selected into your Indian team. So before starting the things, we must set the objective. What exactly we want from that particular thing, that is called as a course objective. Now, after course objective, second term comes called as a course of outcomes. Course outcome means what? This is after learning the things, after doing the things, after learning the subject, what you are capable of, what you are able to do. So on the completion of the course, students will be able to design deterministic Turing machine. So Turing machine, but one word more get added into that called a deterministic Turing machine for all inputs and all outputs, for different inputs, different outputs. So now after learning this subject, you are capable of designing Turing machine with all inputs, all outputs. At the end of these subjects, again this semester, you must able to subdivide the problem space based on the input division using the constraints. So this is called as a modularization. So in your C language, you are writing the different functions, or in the CPP, you are writing the different classes. So what are the different classes or different functions are called as a modularization. So we'll make a different modules of your programs problem, and those problems will solve in the form of the small module. So whether you will learn how to, if some problem is given to you, you are able to subdivide the problem into small parts and the inputs into that subdivision. This input goes to this module subdivision, and this inputs will go to some other part, and at the end collaboratively we are going to make the output. This you are able to do, but very important thing, using the constraints. Constraints are limitations, because as we are the engineer, most probably we are not getting the sufficient resources. But what a good engineer is called as an engineer who can extract best from the limited resources.